6:38, we'll start it out with a look at Isaac. You can see the tropical storm, still a tropical storm swirling, but now out in those warm waters of the Gulf of Mexico, could start to really develop. Here are the latest stats, 65-mile-an-hour winds. It's about 250 miles to the southwest of Fort Myers. It's moving northwest, and that is the track. Now a little farther and farther to the west, heading over toward New Orleans, could make landfall on the 7th anniversary, Wednesday, of Katrina. Then becomes a rainmaker into the Midwest. They certainly could use that rain, although a little late for the corn crop out there. And the question is, where does it go after that? In the meantime, for us, tropical like out there too. Humid. There could be a shower around this morning. They're mainly moving east now. I think we'll get some breaks. We'll see some sun. Not a bad afternoon, but watch out for a late day thunderstorm. They're going to be spotting today. Better bet at showers and storms overnight tonight. Warm, sticky night as we drop down toward 70 degrees. Tomorrow, another humid day, especially to start. There are going to be showers, I think, early in the morning, but then we'll see some sun in the afternoon. You may even notice humidity coming down as northwest winds kick in and starts to clear it out a little bit. Looking live over the Lebanon Valley right now, a little hazy, a little cloudy at this hour. Temperatures, for the most part, are sticky this morning. 68 in Lebanon, dew point at 66. No relief from that breeze. The winds are calm. Gettysburg's at 70. State College at 66. You get the picture. Schmoke in 67. Lancaster right at 70 degrees. And those dew points not far behind. With more moisture in the air, the higher dew points means you can get some pretty heavy downpours. We had a few yesterday out in the parts of Franklin County where we saw the severe weather. Also, pretty heavy rain moved up into parts of York County during the afternoon hours. Lancaster, Lebanon missed it, but now getting some showers. You can see them moving through Lebanon, now moving out of Lancaster County over the last couple of hours and moving off to the east of us. On a wider perspective, there's the tropical system, but here comes another cold front. And that's what's really going to give us our showers. I think this disturbance kind of moves away. High pressure will build in. We'll see some sun. Then we'll see this front start heading in our direction. Could be a shower out ahead of it late today. More likely overnight tonight, early tomorrow morning. Then the question is, well, high pressure gives us nice weather for midweek. But what happens after that? Because there's the storm, the hurricane probably making landfall somewhere out near New Orleans and then moving up into the Tennessee Valley. Does it continue to move up? Does it move west? Right now, it looks like this high is going to block it for at least a part of the weekend. In the meantime, humid day today, sticky tomorrow with some clearing. Then nice midweek. And even Friday looks pretty nice, but getting hotter. The question is, what happens Saturday and Sunday? Well, a couple of scenarios. We could get the leftovers from Isaac and be near 80 with some rain and showers, especially Sunday into Monday. Or it could hold off and not come until Monday or Tuesday. And it's hot and humid, up near 90 for the last blast of summer this Labor Day weekend.
So we can keep an eye here as Isaac. I mean, they were worried right. It was really going to slam Florida. Now it's moved further west, and we'll still kind of wait right. And see what happens after it hits the coast.
We'll try and keep you updated through the week.
You bet. All right, Joe, thank you.